This is Valley News Live at noon.
New for you at noon. A big-time opioid dealer is now sentenced to 10 years in federal prison for narcotic and firearms charges. Officials say 30-year-old Jorge Pitts of Detroit, Michigan, is sentenced 10 years in federal prison for possession with intent to distribute oxycodone and possession of a firearm by a prohibited person. Back in January of 2018, Pitts was stopped for traffic violations in Newtown, North Dakota. Due to Pitts' behavior, authorities executed a search of the vehicle where officers found 1,650 oxycodone pills and a loaded handgun. Pitts later admitted to traveling to the Fort Berthold Indian Reservation from Michigan on multiple occasions, transporting between 800 to 1,000 oxycodone pills for distribution per trip. What a chilly start to the morning, but what should we expect this afternoon? Let's check in with meteorologist Lisa Green.
Good morning. Yes, we started off with some conditions that were quite cold here this morning. Below zero in Fargo for your low at 2 below. And over to the east, even colder. We hit 15 below in Waskish and Bedette, and Bemidji and Park Rapids were at 13 below. But we've since started warming pretty nicely here. We're looking at temperatures mainly in the teens, even some low 20s already. 20 degrees in Grand Forks at 17 in Fargo. So a nice recovery so far here today. Now, we have had a couple of light snow showers working their way through places like Grand Forks, Devil's Lake saw a little bit of that light snow. Even Fargo, we've seen a few flakes and flurries here and there, and this will continue to drop through here as we head into the afternoon. But overall, it's looking fairly quiet with the warmer weather, and some of these snow showers are really diminishing as well. Here's a look at the latest on our First Alert Storm Team Sky Cam in Fargo. You can see still some of those flakes on the camera. And as we continue on into the afternoon, expect temperatures to be in the teens to some low 20s, basically, for everyone here in the valley. We'll have some partly to mostly cloudy skies, too. Some of us just kind of stuck with the clouds. And the wind will remain on the lighter side. So as we're warming up, we don't have to contend with the wind today like we did on Wednesday. We're looking at temperatures starting their slide after sunset, but not too much. It's not going to look as or feel as cold as we were this morning as we head into the weekend. But we do have some snow showers ahead for Saturday and some cold weather ahead too. We'll have your details coming up in your forecast.
Thanks, Lisa. A Minnesota judge says he won't reconsider his decision to hold a March trial for the former Minneapolis police officer who held his knee to George Floyd's neck as a black man said he couldn't breathe. Now, Hennepin County Judge Peter Cahill says Derek Chauvin will stand trial March 8th as scheduled and will be tried separately from the other three former officers who are charged in Floyd's death. Earlier this week, prosecutors asked the judge to reconsider, citing COVID-19 concerns as a primary factor. Chauvin is charged with murder and manslaughter, and the other three officers are charged with aiding and abetting. Outrage on Capitol Hill over the treatment of National Guard troops who answered the call to help protect Washington, D.C. this week. After spending days in the cold securing the U.S. Capitol after the deadly siege two weeks ago, that is. Now, Guard members were forced to vacate the Capitol building and relocate to the nearby parking garage to rest during their shifts. Yesterday afternoon, Capitol Police asked the National Guard to relocate soldiers who were using hallways to rest during their shifts because of increased foot traffic now that the Congress is back in session. About 3,500 guardsmen moved to the garage with heat and restrooms, but some weren't happy because there are limited bathrooms, cell phone and internet service, and power outlets. The decision drew swift condemnation from lawmakers, many calling the move outrageous and offering their own offices for guard members to rest in. After lawmakers lashed out, the order was reversed late last night, and guard troops were ordered to return inside the Capitol overnight. More than half the country is seeing an uptick in COVID-19-related fatalities, and a new study finds the risk of death almost doubles when ICUs are overwhelmed. This as scientists say the new, more contagious UK strain is spreading like wildfire. Erin McLaughlin reports.
Across the country, the staggering COVID death toll is soaring. On Wednesday, more than 4,100 lives lost, the nation's deadliest day on record.
Once it takes hold of a person, it is a slow, energy-sapping, horrible respiratory distress, just a terrible disease to see people go through. There's no treatment. So it really, we're so reliant on this vaccine.
As the nation looks to the vaccine for relief, frustration for the newest group eligible for shots. Those 65 and older, spiking demand for an already inadequate supply, while they try to navigate overwhelmed websites and face wait times of up to 8 hours in some places.
Not quite sure what's going on. It's very frustrating.
Scientists say the current pace of vaccine distribution is no match for the new, more contagious UK variant. The CDC expects it to become the more dominant strain by March.
Today, it appears that the vaccines will still be effective against them. With the caveat in mind, you want to pay close attention to it.
And some warn even more precautions are necessary to stop the virus spread.
We all need much, much higher quality masks in any sort of high-risk situation. If you find yourself in an indoor space, a grocery store, or in an office building around other people, a simple cloth mask is probably not enough for this very contagious variant.
This is hospitals are already pushed to the brink in states such as Arizona, where more than 100,000 of the 700,000 confirmed cases are children.
Over the past 3 months since the surge started again, we've seen a 5 to 6-fold increase in COVID hospitalizations in children. It has affected the children just as it has adults.
Erin McLaughlin, NBC News.
Experts recommend you upgrade your mask for higher risk activities sooner rather than later. They point to KN95 mask or FN94s, and if you can't find those, experts say look for a surgical mask or double up that cloth mask for extra protection. The CDC has upgraded its guidance about when a person should get the coronavirus vaccine second dose. The recommended time between doses is 21 days for Pfizer vaccine and 28 days for the Moderna's vaccine. However, the CDC now says that while the second dose should be administered as close to the recommended time as possible, it can be scheduled up to 6 weeks later if necessary. Also, the agency says it is only exceptional situations where a person can get the second dose that comes from a different vaccine, with the full story at 4 as well. Ford is recalling 3 million vehicles to replace Takata airbags that could explode in a crash. That defect prompted the largest automobile recall in U.S. history of more than 67 million vehicles. Safety regulators ordered Ford to recall the driver's side airbags, which the company had resisted for the past few years. Affected vehicles include older model Ford Rangers, Fusion, Ledge, and Lincoln MKZ. Hank Aaron, Baseball Hall of Famer and one-time home run king, has died, according to the MLB Network. Aaron was 86 years old. He spent most of his baseball career playing for the Braves in Milwaukee and Atlanta, finishing his careers with 755 home runs. Hank broke Babe Ruth's home run record in 1974. He was elected to the Baseball Hall of Fame in 1982. Aaron was born in Mobile, Alabama, where the former minor league ballpark is named after him. Well, coming up at noon, see why some researchers believe the pandemic may be doing more good than bad. And we have a full look at weather coming up next with meteorologist Lisa Green.